What's up, guys? Instructor Smiley. Today we're going to be going over red dots on pistols. Welcome back to my channel, guys. I appreciate all you guys that are following up with me and keeping up with me during this COVID-19 crap. Today it just dawned on me that I haven't spoken about red dots on pistols yet. I am a huge advocate of running a red dot on my pistol. So let's go over the starting, right? The integrative act of firing. Why red dots work. So let's go over why people want to use iron sights versus red dots, all right? When you're using iron sights, there's typically no failure, right? There's no battery, there's not one dot. You don't have to worry about any electronical failure. But let's go over why they're slightly slower, at least in my opinion, right? So the integrative act of firing. You have your front sight post. You have your rear sights, all right? You have to line both of them up together, equal height, equal light, right? Now that you have that on paper, your front sights are lined up. You have to go ahead and shift your focus from your rear sight to your front sight and make sure you have good sight picture. If you don't know what sight picture is, essentially, if my hand is the target, I have my sights in front of my hand, that's good sight picture, right? Making sure that your sights are on your target, essentially, in smaller words. But now that my focus is there, right, I have a bunch of blur. The only thing that's clear is the very tip of my front sight. That's a lot of steps, if you ask me, right? When you have a red dot, all right, depending on the red dot you have, I run the Holosun series. This is the 507C. It's a single 2MOA dot. It's literally just one dot. So the way that red dots work, if you put that red dot on the target after zeroing it and making sure it's set up right, there's no alignment necessary. You don't have to worry about too much. I don't have to put two things together. All I have to do is put my sight, like my red dot, on the target and squeeze the trigger as necessary in a correct fundamental way so I can get shots on paper. So in essence, it's faster, right? If you're a shooter who's been shooting for a while with iron sights, it might be a little difficult for you to jump into the red dot game because you're so used to coming out of the holster and looking for this, right? Once you find that, you're good to go. People that are somewhat newer to shooting should be easier with red dots because it's a little bit more to pick up. It's a little less to pick up. It's a lot easier to get the idea of it, but still train with irons. A big issue people have with their red dots, right? So my pistol's safe and clear. Is that when people are shooting them, they're having this problem where they're having to go ahead and quote-unquote find the dot. In my opinion, that is a training deficiency. It's just like your iron sights. If I pull right out of my holster and my sights come up like this or like that or like that, what do people typically do? They adjust, right? They figure out which way they need to move the gun to grab it. But if they've been training for a while, when they come out the holster, they don't need to adjust because they're so used to coming out that one way, muscle memory kicks in, and your sights will be there every single time, right? So I'm going to go ahead and play a video real quick of me shooting with the red dot so you guys can see how fast target accuracy. Shout out to the guys at Spec Train. They hooked me up with that video. Dope class. If you guys get a chance and you're in North Carolina area, go check out Spec Train. But if you're watching the video and you're watching my fundamentals, right? Gun comes out of holster. Soon as my arms are fully extended, my dot is found and I'm on target. I squeeze the trigger. I run out of ammo. I do a quick rapid reload. Soon as the mag's in and it's turned, guess what? I find my dot again. So essentially, when it's finding the dot, when it's time to find it, if you train it and practice it, it comes up quicker. Now, people that enjoy running iron sights run the same argument. Oh, it's the same way when you go ahead and you run iron. If you train hard enough, you can go ahead and pick them up all the time, essentially. Yes, that's true. But in my opinion, I like running the red dot. I think it's more innovative. I think it's less steps. Also, I am a left eye dominant shooter and I'm right-handed. So that's a whole nother phase that I get into, but I don't have to worry about that with the red dot. Another good reason for red dots is they're faster when you're transitioning from targets. So if I'm here and I have one single point of reference and I go there, bang, bang, back to there, there's no movement in the dot. It's just a single dot going there and there. When you're running sights, right, and you have it here and you're there, when it's time to snap, you can risk risk moving your sights and not having perfect alignment when you get there. Your sights can be here, they can be there, just pretty much in the way that you're moving the gun, all right? Because it's two separate things. They can line up differently when you get there versus a red dot. Think about why people use red dots on rifle. It's quicker, it's faster. Not everybody wants to run iron sights, right? especially when a lot of people, when they are firing iron sights, I forgot to mention this earlier, critical information, they close one eye, right? So they're here, they're finding their sights, boom, they're good to go. With red dots, I don't need to do that because I don't need to go ahead and focus too hard on that front sight post because there's one dot. So now with me being able to have both eyes open, I have my peripherals over here and over there, and I can still focus on my dot with no issues. So that's another thing. I'm going to show a video, another SpecTrain video that I did where we're shooting multiple targets, and watch how quick I transition from target to target. Video, right? So I'm turning around, they say go. The purpose of this drill was they have targets 1 through 4 set up, and they tell you while you're facing the cadre, it's 4 targets, 2, 4, 1, 3. That's the order you have to shoot them in, right? They mix them up, they mix them up so they're not stacked on top of each other, and then they say threat. When you turn around, I have to go ahead and identify each target and shoot them. Now, if I'm running iron sights, and this is just me, some of you guys that are iron sight masters out there, most likely aren't going to enjoy red dots. I don't hear a lot of guys that love running iron sights run red dots. They always have something to complain about. I'm optimistic. I like both. But most of them, when I'm seeing this and I have to turn around and my adrenaline's pumping, I start to blur out. Now, what I mean by blur out is I don't see this anymore. I kind of just see my target because I'm so used to this right there. It's there, but I'm not focused on it. I'm kind of just putting all three in the center of the target and going there. Am I going to hit my target? No doubt, especially within the distance I am. I think we're at 7 yards. Now, am I going to accurately stack shots like I would like to? Probably not, because my adrenaline's pumping and not all my fundamentals might be together, especially if you're a new shooter. You might not have all of it together. So when you're running a red dot, it's a lot less stressful when it's time to just turn around, snap, all you get to focus on is the dot. Excuse me. So when it's time to move from target to target, my gunner's safe and clear. This is my carry pistol, my Glock 45. When I come out, it's red dot on target, bang, 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 bang. Versus having something with iron sights where I have to catch my alignment every single time. All right, and another thing when it comes to that, being able to have that open window with that red dot, again, allows your peripherals to be there. When you're focused on your iron sights and you close that one eye, even if you don't, this eye is not in use, it's not focused. So it's a blur. So now you're coming from this target that you're focusing on to there, blurring out the targets here, here, and here. You don't wanna do that. You wanna be able to see every single thing. Right. One more drill I'm going to show you guys that I ran with SpecTrain. They had us running back and forth from targets. Now, again, when your adrenaline's up and you're trying to accurately hit shots, things become a little bit more difficult, especially if you don't train super, super hard in that area. So you want something that's going to be a lot easier for you to grasp, but also a lot smarter. So as I'm running through and hitting the targets, my adrenaline's coming up and I have to focus on all of my fundamentals at once. Having a red dot makes the integrative act of firing and aiming slightly easier. So there you go. Where you see me going from target to target. There's three targets. I run to the furthest one, pistol comes out. Bam, bam, run, bam, 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 bam. I like that drill because it kind of pushes you, gets your heart rate up, and lets you know how well you're doing. Me personally, with iron sights doing that drill, it's going to take me a little bit longer because one, I have to go ahead and measure my distance, so where I want to aim at in the silhouette, and two, I have to get my sights aligned. Going there with the red dot, I don't have to do that. Aim center with the red dot's on target, bam, move on, right? Now that you guys have been convinced, if you have, that you want to go ahead and put a red dot on your pistol, next thing you want to look at is going ahead and finding the correct red dot for you that's going to go ahead and match your mission. So on my carry pistols, I run the Hollow Sun series, right? This is the new 508T, the Gen 1. And then on my old carry pistol, I ran the 507C. I went Hollow Sun because it met everything I needed, right? They have the gold standard out there, the Trigicon RMR. Me personally, I think the RMR is a great optic. I just don't want to pay $500 for it. The Trigicon RMR is a great optic. People use it. It's damn near bomb-proof. I don't need all that for every day. I want something that if I drop it, it's still going to work, but not something that I think I'm going to take into combat with me because I'm not doing that with these pistols. These are my carry pistols. So go ahead and figure out what works for you. I would definitely check out the Hollow Sun series. They're great optics. Go ahead and check out Sage Dynamics. He has a great video pretty much a torture test of the optic, showing you everything you need to know about that specific optic. Excuse me. I'll be doing another review in the next couple weeks on the Swamp Fox Optic Kingslayer Red Dot. It's another affordable optic. We're going to see how well it holds up. Just to give you guys a little visual, this is my first Hollow Sun. It's at about 3,500 rounds and still holding zero, still running like a champ. So that is great. I'll be doing a separate video on how I feel about the difference between the 508 and the 507 later. But that's it for now. I appreciate you guys watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, comment. If you guys are looking for holsters, go ahead and check out Kerber Arms. I'll leave a link in my bio. If you guys are looking for a high-quality rifle, but you don't want to pay anywhere from $1,200 to $1,500, go ahead and check out Kratos Tactical. Rusty over there is great, and he's going to hook you guys up. I'll be doing a review on one of their rifles very, very soon as well. If you guys have any questions, you're more than welcome to message me on Instagram. I reply super, super quick. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe, tag somebody, and I'll see you guys later.